In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to turn an old computer into a network attached storage or NAS. The hardware requirements are a PC with a minimum of 192 megabytes of RAM, with a keyboard, monitor, Ethernet connection, a bootable CD drive, and a hard drive. You also need another PC with a CDRW drive and a blank CDR disk and a connection to the local network. First, you need to download the FreeNAS 7 ISO image from the wiki.freenas.org. Burn a CD of the FreeNAS 7 ISO image file. Boot the PC from the CD. Next, you'll wait until the screen displays FreeNAS menu. Press 9 on the keyboard for install slash upgrade to hard drive slash flash device. Press enter. Press 2 on the keyboard for install embed OS on the HDD slash hard drive USB plus data swap partition. The FreeNAS installation will make partition 2 for data storage. Press enter. Select your CD drive, press enter, then select your hard drive, and then press enter. Select no for swap partition, unless you have a few gigs of RAM, and the partition should be 2 times the amount of RAM installed in your computer. The CD will now format the hard drive to UFS file system. The FreeNAS will install it onto a small partition of your, press enter. Select exit. Press 7 on your keyboard to restart the computer. Press enter. Remove the FreeNAS live CD, and then wait until FreeNAS to boot into your computer. Press 1 on your keyboard to assign interfaces. Pick your Ethernet port from the list, usually the first option. Press enter. Press enter again to proceed. Pick none, finish, and exit. Press enter. Press 2 on your keyboard to set LAN IP address. Using DHCP should be fine unless you're using a static IP, in which case you can hit no and assign it yourself. Press enter. Press enter to configure IPv or Internet Protocol version 6, then press enter to enable auto configuration. Then FreeNAS will output an IP address. That IP address will allow you to access the web interface to configure everything on your NAS. Write down or remember the IP address because we will be using it to configure the NAS. Now you can unhook your keyboard and monitor from your NAS. You won't need them anymore. Go to another PC to configure your FreeNAS server. Access the web interface by opening up your web browser and type in the IP address you copied down at the end of the installation process. Username is admin. Password is FreeNAS. To change the username and password, click on Systems menu at the top of the page. Change the username and password. Add hard drive to FreeNAS by clicking on the Disk menu at the top of the page. Click Management, then click on the plus sign to add a new hard drive. Choose your disk from the disk drop-down menu. And click Add. The rest of the default settings should be fine for now. Click Apply Settings back on the disk management page. Next, we need to assign a mount point to the hard drive. Click Disk Mount Point from the top menu. And click the plus sign. Click your disk from the drop-down menu. Select MVR partition type. Select partition number 2, since FreeNAS has set partition 2 for data storage. Then name the mount point. Next, click on Add button once again. Hit Apply Settings. Next, we will share the drive with other computers on the network. Click Services, CIFS, SMB, and hit Enable checkbox in the right corner. Select Anonymous for authentication and NT1 for MAX protocol. Select Anonymous for authentication and NT1 for MAX protocol. Scroll down and hit Save and Restart. Click on the Shares tab at the top of the Settings page. Click the plus sign. Give it a name. hit the three dot button to tell it which of your FreeNAS drives you want to share. The default setting should be fine for most people, so go ahead and hit add. Hit apply settings. Next we'll allow easy access to your NAS drive. Right click on your NAS drive and select map network drive to put it under my computer. You should be able to do this with every other computer on the network and easily share files between all of those computers. You can now drag and drop files to your NAS drive.